Okay.
All right, brother.
Thanks. Oh, it's that?
Yeah.
That's why.
So this is the Triumph Tiger 1200 XCA. The astute among you may have already determined that this bike is a 2017 model. Although it is new, it is 2017.
See what we've got here. Pretty comfortable bike. Nice seating position. A lot lower seat than my bike.
I'd like to start out by thanking Royal Enfield of Milwaukee for allowing me to ride this great bike today. So while I'm trying to find a place to park this thing and do a walk around, I'll run through a couple of the specs. So this is a liquid cooled 12 valve, double overhead cam, inline 3-cylinder, 1200 cc's. It makes about 140 horsepower. I know the claims are just slightly higher than that. I wasn't able to see any dyno testing to see what it actually is, but it doesn't really matter. It's a 1200 cc bike. They make plenty of power. It has 90 foot-pounds of torque claimed. This is another ride-by-wire fuel-injected bike. It is a shaft drive, 6-speed gearbox. It does have a tubular steel trellis frame, a single-sided cast aluminum alloy swing arm, and then the wheels on this particular bike are spoked, although there is on the cheaper versions there is a cast aluminum alloy wheel available as well. The suspension is done both front and rear by White Power, which is super nice. The brakes are Brembo in the front and Nissan in the back. The bike claimed weight is about 535 pounds, holds 5 gallons. That should put you somewhere around the 200 mile range. It does have a nice, what they call a normal seat height for an adventure bike, which means it's probably a tick tall. If you're a medium height person, meaning 5'8 to 5'10, it's gonna fit you pretty well. So let's fast forward up to a spot where we can take a look at some of these features I just talked about.
This thing on the center stand, as you may have seen, the starting sequence is great, but one thing I do want to say is, boy, these Triumph does a really good job with these actual off-road foot pegs, and they are nice. So if we take a look at this thing, this is the XCA. See, it's got spoked wheels and lend itself to better off-road wear and tear, or better off-road usage. It's a pretty normal looking machine. Other than that, you've got kind of a lower hanging skid plate, there is a skid plate actually underneath to protect those pipes, because they are fairly low to the ground. You kind of wonder how they do if you had some real off-road terrain to look at. So this is the triple, makes about 140 horsepower, plenty of power for these big open bikes are just the best. Anything of these leader displacement bikes are just super nice, lots of power. Reasonable, what I'd call reasonable mileage anyways. You can see this one's outfitted with all the luggage and racks from the factory. They look like a pretty nice setup. Shaft drive, disc brakes, and disc brakes by Brembo, in fact, so you got a really high quality braking setup. A lot of these bikes have a lot of switches and gadgets, and any more, boy, you can just fine-tune the ride to whatever you want. And you got some nice things like this up and down windshield, and maybe it was down and maybe it's got to go up. Or maybe it doesn't go when you're moving, who knows.
Or maybe I'm just too stupid to figure out how to use this windshield.
But right, wind's coming up a little bit. Lake Michigan's getting a little choppier. Yeah, I would just say this clutch is adjusted so far out at the end of the throw that You have a little bit of ambiguity there when the clutch is actually engaging. It's nice and smooth. It's just an adjustment matter.
So another thing that I've noticed right away is this is a bike that's not equipped with a quick shift. And it's not the end of the world. The bike shifts very well. It's smooth, it's positive. It's just that once you get used to not using the clutch or not having to fan the clutch a little bit on a shift, boy, it feels like you're going backwards pretty far.
The Triumph has kind of a neat sound. It's this triple is, like I said, it's nice and smooth. Just about zero vibration coming back to the rider. And you can see here we're going along about 60 miles an hour. We're not, setting the world on fire or anything, but this is a very comfortable ride.
I think another thing we have to mention is just how adjustable all of these newer bikes are, and the Triumph is no exception. You can dial yourself into just about any single riding position, firmness, stiffness, softness, power. It really is amazing, and their menu on the Triumph is nice. It's concise. It's easy to scroll through and easy to select what your personal preferences are. And the bike does respond differently to each one of these adjustments. I went through about six of them here, both on the braking, the handling, and you could feel a change every single time you selected it.
You know, plenty of, even though we're running on a, of course, break-in style riding mode. There's plenty of power. That's the nice thing about these big bikes is you don't always have to use all that power. You can use a little bit of it, use less fuel, but it's always there if it's needed.
Now, as far as first impressions go with the Triumph 1200 XCA, is this is another bike where there's just not a lot not to like. It's another well put together machine that's got all of the amenities that you could hope for. The heated seat is amazing. The heated grips are, in my opinion at least, a must have up here in Wisconsin where we ride. But it's really, this is really a great machine.
And we're back here at Royal Enfield of Milwaukee.
Well, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Ride safe, and we'll see you out there.